Hi guys, welcome back. So last time I showed you how to make some flowers and stuff like that for your greenhouse out of ordinary store-bought flowers. So if you didn't watch part one, go ahead and watch that now so that you can get an idea of what flower arrangements we're going to be using for our little garden stuff here. All right, so I'm going to set these on the side because they're kind of in my way right now. And then we're going to start off with these big plants. Last time I showed you how to make a hosta out of that. This time I'm just going to show you how to make a freestanding little plant that you can use for your greenhouse. It's the simplest one that I have done yet, so it's going to be really easy and there's not much to it. If you're using this, you will need to put some hot glue in your little container. Don't burn yourself. You want to let it cool down until this glue gets very cloudy. That way you don't burn yourself and the glue becomes pliable and doesn't melt your items that you're trying to stick in it. I'm also using a cap that is a wire nut. I'm going to stick that in there. Let that sink down in that a little bit as well. So let those two get pliable. If you have a way, you can cut this off or you can leave it like that. And this is just a cap and you can use that as well for your plants. Lots of other little containers and lids and eyedropper bottles. Pretty much anything. This one here, you can cut off and make an oblong plant. You can cut it again, make several different little containers out of this one, and I'll show you that in another tutorial, or you can go back and watch some of the older videos that I did with plants. Under dollhousetutorials.com, there's a list of like landscaping and flowers and stuff like that, and there's a lot of different videos on there how to mess with stuff that you're using for your garden and your yard and things like that. So this is starting to get cloudy, but it's not quite cloudy. This one's going to cool off a little bit quicker because it's got some metal in there, but it's almost there because the top is just a little bit much. This one here is getting there, but you can still see it's pretty clear, and to touch it, it's very, very hot. When you're doing plastic, you need to be very careful because it will melt through if you do too much. So again, watch part one and you'll see how I did the plastic so it didn't melt as quickly. And it held the glue. These containers, if you're interested in getting any of those, leave a question, suggestion, or comment below and let me know what your thoughts are, because if enough people like them, I'll start putting them on my Etsy shop. The greenhouse is also on the Etsy shop. Okay, so for this one, I just pulled off one of the little stalks of leaves and I'm going to give you the option. You could put three of them together and have a very, very full plant, or you can just have one freestanding. For me, I'm just going to do the one freestanding for now, and then for some reason they have a weird coating on them, so before you do it, you want to go ahead and like clear off your leaves, or you can leave it on there and have that white look on there. I'm not sure why they're like that. I think it's like whatever they put on it to keep them from sticking together or something. But I'm going to go ahead and put this one in this one here, I think. And I'm going to kind of let it get wet there a little bit so it gets down in there and then that glue becomes pliable. And that way when I go later on in a different video, I will go back and flock these. And if you want to know how to make flock, I've got lots of tutorials on that as well under the grass section. So you want to hold it until it finishes cooling the rest of the way. Make sure you keep your bottom flat so it doesn't get too wobbly. Oh, this one's got a little nip in it. That's why. Okay, I have to sand that off. Okay, so while that's cooling off the rest of it, I'm going to lean it up against here. I put a little bit more glue in there because I wanted to add an extra leaf in the front where it was bare, so it's still a little warm. This one is almost hardened, so we kind of need to work with that. Hopefully it didn't harden too much. And it did. Okay, so if that happens, take your hot glue gun and just kind of press it down in that hole. That's what I get for trying to do two things at once. Okay, now, let's see if it's too hot. I'm gonna put this in here, and this one I'm gonna have to probably add some to. This one's getting a little bit top heavy on me. I'm gonna take this. And a few of the leaves, if I can get it to hold still long enough. Just kind of fill in those little spots where the leaves are not there, but it's also kind of dominant there. Let's see if it's going to stand. Yeah, it's going to stand. So that is how you fix that. Who knew, right? Maybe put a little bit in there. A little bit there, and I don't know if I want to put another one in the back or not yet. Let me see what it looks like. Maybe a shorter one might look okay. Let's see. I don't know if I like that. I think that's too tall. Let's try a little bit shorter. Let's see what happens here. All right, that's not too bad. So I think I'll do that. And then I am also going to run a bead of hot glue right up the back of this and right up the back of this, because I want to make that stand up a little bit more on that. So I'm going to kind of try and make it attach itself. So this here, I'm gonna put a little bit of glue on there. Not a lot, because I don't want to melt my leaves. Oop, that just kind of dripped out way too much. Because I don't want to get burnt, I'm just going to squeeze it together with my pliers. Let's see if it still stands. Yes, it still stands. So there's that, and that's kind of leaning a little bit there. It's leaning that way. If I wanted to add a few more leaves, like maybe one right in there to look like it's coming out of there, we could do that. Might add one here as well. I think kind of just covering it a bit. If I can see what I'm doing, trying to reach around. That's not really the best way to do that when you're reaching for glue. Just gonna kind of put that right there, just kind of covering it just a tiny bit, but enough to where you still see it and it looks like the leaves are growing in between the flowers. Might even put that in there, I think. I don't know what it'll look like. I mean, if it doesn't turn out, it's not like I don't have a zillion more, so we're just gonna wing it and see if that works. Tell me what your thoughts are, with or without that middle one, and maybe I'll make some more. But I just think in the middle here is a little bare, so we'll see. That's it right there for that one, and move all the stuff out the way. Let's see if it's gonna stand. There it goes, it does stand. Okay, so that's great. It stands. I'm gonna have lots more stuff for inside of my little greenhouse. Got some flowers, some bushes, some roses, or not really roses, but whatever you want to call them. I guess they could be considered roses if you did it enough. Okay, so this one we're going to do the same thing we did before with the purple one. I'm going to cut some of these little balls off. And now we're getting down to the bigger ones. We're just going to cut them like that. Okay, so got two more filled with glue here. Getting a little cloudy on us. And then we have all of these. So we can kind of stick them this way or this way. And you can just do one little flower in there like that. And then you can do a couple of these little yellow green flower leaves. It's kind of sinking down in there because it's still very warm. So we may have to add a second one on top. Since that sunk down a little bit, I'm gonna push it down a little bit more. And then I'm just gonna add another one on top. And remember, you can cross your leaves different directions. They don't have to all be uniform. And then there you go, you have a little tiny plant with a pink flower in it. Very similar to this one. I think this one turned out cuter though, personally. And that came off of the first tutorial. I really like that one. So basically, you can just do any like floral arrangement that has small leaves in it, and just look at them closely, because some of them have leaves that are small and you don't even know it until you get up close. This one I'm just going to kind of have standing straight up, and I'm going to mix a couple of the green ones in with it too, so it kind of looks like it's either maybe dying off or sprouting new. You know, your imagination can be whatever you want it to be. Because guess what? Miniatures don't talk unless they're talking to you. And everybody knows when you're doing miniature, a house will talk to you and tell you what to do when you're designing it. So that's what I mean by that. I want something with a little bit more yellow in it, so this one will go. Okay, so now this is pliable, so I'm going to just kind of squish that together at the bottom. And then there you have that. Alright, so one more last thing I'm going to show you is this little teeny tiny plant here. I took the same leaves as I did for this one, which is this one here that I got at Hobby Lobby. And I cut it up and put it in there. Well, then I took one of the ones that I got from Dollar Tree that has the little flowers that are long on it, like that. And I cut the little flowers up in the itty bits and pieces. And I took the first one and I put a little bit of glue right down one there, and then I glued it right within there. So there's a bigger one at the bottom. Then I took some smaller bits that I have with the little flower pieces sticking out very carefully, put some glue on there. And then I just glued them to the leaves to make it look like it has flowers growing on it. And that one don't have much on it, so we'll get a different one. Be very, very careful when you're doing this, and I'm just rubbing it on there. You might want to use some tweezers or something, because the glue does get hot. Or you could use probably some super glue, maybe. Those are too little to mess with without tweezers. But you get the idea of what I've done. Now this one, we talked about making tomatoes out of it. But for this here, I just went ahead and used the little bunch that I got from Walmart. It was a bunch of different things in there. And I just made a little plant. That's also the same one we made the hostas out of. That one is a little top heavy. It doesn't fall over if you are just leaving it sit there, but if you bump into it, it does fall. And again, these leaves on mine, they seem to have like a coating of some sort of powder. I don't know why, but it does. But that's what I made for my greenhouse today. I'll show you some of the other ones that I made as well. And then, stay tuned. Check out dollhousetutorials.com. I'll post some stuff on there. Like, subscribe, leave a question, suggestion, or comment below. And then you'll see when I post more videos, as well as I do a lot of laser stuff now. So that is definitely something that if you're interested in Dollhouse kits, this is just one of the kits that I did. I designed this myself, and you can get it on my Etsy shop. As I knock everything over. Okay, so let me show you some of the flowers and stuff that I have in here. So this, someone that I know saved me these because they used, I guess, like those electric cigarettes or something. And that was like one of the things that I used it to make a flower out of. This was a lid. And this is what I was talking about earlier about melting the plastic. As you can see, that plastic got melted. And then this was just a plastic palm tree that I took that was one of the kids when they were little. This was another plastic tree, but this was from an aquarium, and I'm using a copper bottom. These are paper flowers that I designed, and they're in a lid. The tutorials for most of these are on my website already. And then these are some silk combinations. These are paper. And then that's those. This one is my favorite because it was like just out of the blue. It looks like little daisies, but believe it or not, this is a straw. These are little pieces of a straw. I used the part that curled into the circle to put it like that, and then I cut it in half and then glued it the way I wanted it. More little flower arrangements. Okay, so if you have spray bottles from your cleaning products, that's what this is. You can see the on and off, but when it's in there around all the flowers, you don't see it. And again, that's another arrangement that I found, and I just cut the pieces down to fit. This is a second one that's like that. Again, here's another one just like that with the leaves. And then this one is a paper flower that's made with quilling. Let's see, what else do I got in here? This is the same as the ones that we just did with this. The only difference is it's blue. And I actually took one of the cream colored ones. If I can get it separated, I'll show you. One of the cream colored ones, and I took a marker and just colored it. That way it has two different variations of the blue on there. And it's in a blue cap. This is also quilling paper with a green line down the middle of it. This one I made from plastic from one of the recycled bottles. I glued it in there and then I painted it. This is another one that's made out of that cream. And I think that may be it. Let me see. Oh, nope, there's one more in there. This is paper, and then these are punches. And then that's made with a miniature flower pot that's wooden that I got from the hobby store. guys. Well, leave a question, suggestion, or comment below, and I will see you in the next video. And remember, this kit is on my Etsy shop. Thanks a lot. Have a wonderful, wonderful day.